made for tea. The biggest and the best. خذنا نحن المقارنة comparative and superlative في الدروس الماضية، وعرفنا متى نضيف ER than، متى نضيف more than، في حالة superlative متى نضيف the EST، وأيضا most. Geography a beach, desert, forest, hill, mountain, island, جزيرة, lake, mountain, ocean, river, valley, volcano. Balcony, waterfall, شلال، أو volcano، أيضا قنبل، volcano، okay. Which is larger? Which is larger? Here is a geography quiz in the paper. Oh, I love geography. Ask me the questions. Sure. First question. Which country is larger, China or Canada? I know. Canada is larger than China. Okay, next. What is the longest river in the Americas? I think it's the Mississippi. Mississippi River. Here is a hard one. Which country is more crowded? Monaco or Singapore? I'm not sure. I think Monaco is more crowded. Oh, one more. Which South American capital city is the highest? La Paz, Quito, or Bogota? Oh, that's easy. Bogota is the highest. Let's go to the grammar focus. خلينا نضيف ER حالة الصفات one syllable، مقطع واحد أو الصفات القصيرة، أو two three syllables الصفات الطويلة. وعندنا أيضا irregular adjectives الصفات الشاذة. Which country is larger؟ okay. شو الصفات؟ Long، longer، the، longest، dry، drier، the، driest. في حالة إضافة ER أو EST، Y قبل أي حرف غير الحروف العلة تحول لـ I. Dryer the driest. Big حرف قبل حرف علة ندبل الحرف الأخير. Big bigger biggest. Famous famous two syllable صفة طويلة. More famous the most famous. Beautiful, more beautiful, the most beautiful. Good, better, best. Bad, worse, the worst. شوف التمرين. Complete questions 1 to 4 with comparatives and questions 5 to 8 with superlative. Okay. Number 1. Which country is comparative يعني نضيف ER. Which country is smaller? Okay. Number 2. Which waterfall is higher? Higher. Number 3. Which city is more crowded? So the power two syllables. Number 4, last of comparatives. Which lake is larger? Good. Number 5, superlatives. Which is لازم نضيف the which is the highest الأعلى. Okay. Number 6. What is the longest river? Number 7. Which city is the most تكلم عن superlative. Which city is the most expensive? Which is the deepest superlative? Deepest ocean in the world. نقدر نضيف سواء comparatives أو superlatives، لكن حسب طلب السؤال. الأربعة الأولى comparatives، الأربعة الثانية superlatives. Okay. Our recommendations for graph number 1. I really like quiet places where I can relax, hike, and enjoy the views. I can't stand big crowds. I can't stand big crowds. Number 2. Yes, who can read? Number 1. Test your world knowledge. اختبر معلوماتك. France is the most popular country to visit. It has about 76 million visitors a year. The most popular country. China has the greatest number of stores in the world. The greatest. Okay. There are over 19 million stores. Lake Baikal in Russia is the deepest lake on Earth. It is 1,637 meters deep. Very deep. Tokyo Disneyland is the world's most popular amusement park. It has over 25 million visitors a year. How many Disneylands are there in the world? How many Disneylands do you know? There will be a Disneyland in Dubai as well, I guess. Okay. The largest or the longest non-stop flight is from New York to Singapore. The longest non-stop flight is from New York to Singapore. It is 18 hours long. What do you think? Let's discuss. If you are in a plane from New York to Singapore, you will be in the flight about 18 hours. What will you do for this long time distance? What would you do if you are in this long time distance? 18 hours long. Some people sleep in planes, but no one can sleep for 18 hours. You can sleep for like 7 hours, 10 hours. And now they are declining or rejecting iPods and iPads. You can take these devices with you on the plane. It will be very boring, very boring. Reading books, watching films, maybe play games. Very long time. next one. The biggest airport in the world is London. London Heathrow Airport, with over 55 million passengers a year. 55 million passengers a year is more than Saudi Arabia population. Canada has the longest coastline of any country on earth. It is 243,792 kilometers long. Coastline means bus lines. Okay, bus lines. Last one, Easter Island. It is the world's most isolated island. I don't know what does isolated mean. Island. It is about 3,700 kilometers from South American continent. Maybe in the end of the year. Very far. Isolated. Maybe it means very far. Okay. I'm not sure. Distance and measurements. SU JASON measurements. Okay. I am going to Australia next year. Aren't you from Australia, Beth? Actually, I am from New Zealand. Oh, I didn't know that. So, what's it like there? Oh, it's beautiful. It has lots of forms and it's very mountains. Really, how high are the mountains? Well, the highest one is Mount Cook. It is about 3,800 meters high. 3,800 meters high. How far is New Zealand from Australia? Well, I live in Auckland, and Auckland is about 2,000 kilometers from Sydney. Well, maybe I should visit you next year too. Look at this question with how we studied this. As I told you, how comes with adjectives. You can say how far, how big, how high, how deep, how long, how hot, how cold, how good, how beautiful, how happy. Any adjective. It comes for measurement, for giving numbers, giving sizes, giving length. Okay. How far is New Zealand? How far is Jeddah from Mecca? Okay. We can use kilometers. We can use miles. How big is Singapore? How big is Singapore? It is 648 square meters, kilometers. How high? How deep is the Grand Canyon? It is about 1900 or 1900 meters deep. How long is the Mississippi River? Kilometers long. We should use long, deep, high at the end of the numbers. How tall are you? I am 160 centimeters tall, because I started the question with tall. How hot is Auckland in the summer? Okay. How hot? It gets up to about 23 Celsius. It's not very hot. How cold is it in the winter? How hot? Make questions for these answers. Read the answers and try to make some questions. Last session, I give you a homework about tourist guide, tourist article. Okay? And you give me some information about some nice places in Saudi Arabia to visit. This is another one. Korea's best kept secret. Korea is one of the most interesting countries in the world. There is a fascinating mix of both ancient and modern in is a small northeast Asian country. It is famous for its beautiful landscape, rich culture, and delicious food. One of the most popular places to visit is Jeju Island, located off the southern coast. Okay, I need you to think about a country, not in Saudi Arabia, outside Saudi Arabia. Try to speak about the culture of Egypt, the culture of Rome, the culture of India, the famous old historical places of Madain Saleh and the pyramids, the seventh wonder of the world. Try to pick up a country and give some information about their people, about their places, their food, historical places, traditions. Okay? Good article. You can search in the internet and give me some information as a tourist guide outside of Saudi Arabia. Okay? Tell me informations about the mountains there, about the rivers, waterfalls, volcanoes. You can speak about Japan, China. It has a lot of volcanoes and forests. You can speak about Americans or Americas. Amazon, Mississippi, it has a lot of mountains and rivers and forests. You can just give me, I need the sizes, I need information, like history information, okay? I need to see your writings. And send me your writings on WhatsApp, okay? Or in my email as well. No problem. Things you can do to help the environment. Things you can do to help the environment. Yes. Who can read? Unit 15, I am going to a soccer match. Soccer means a football match. Okay? Soccer is American. Football is British. Okay? I am going to. Going to in present continuous. Present progressive. I am going to soccer match now. Okay? Making excuses. Making excuses. How to make excuses if someone invites you. If someone invites you. How to say these excuses. Some common excuses for not accepting an invitation. Someone invites you for a wedding, for a party, for a dinner, for graduation. Use these excuses to avoid them. I can't. My parents are visiting from out of town. Means my parents coming to me. Okay? My parents are visiting from out of town. Some of these excuses are lying, telling a lie. It's not real, but you're saying these excuses to avoid people. Number two, I am busy. I am busy that night. Let's make an invitation. Could you come to my wedding next week? No, I'm sorry. I am busy that day. I'm busy that night. Okay? Like this. I am sorry. I can't find a babysitter. I can't find a babysitter. It means I can't find someone looks after my baby. Your friend asking you to visit her tomorrow night, but you don't want to go. You say, I can't find a babysitter. I have to stay with my kids. Okay? I am not feeling well. This is a big lie. This is a big lie. Like when I tell you and ask you, can you speak? Can you read? No, no. I'm not feeling well. because you're not feeling well. You are feeling well, but you don't like to read. Not feeling well. I have to work. I have to work. I just got a new puppy. I have to stay home with it. I don't know what puppy means here, but I feel it is a cat or a dog. Okay? I have class that night. We have class that night. No one have classes at nights. But you say an excuse. I have classes that night. My favorite TV show is on that night. I can't come to your party, to your birthday party, because my favorite show is on that night. I have to get up early next morning. Really good excuses. Making plans. We use present continuous in future as well. We use present continuous in future, but to make plans for near future. استخدم present continuous for making plans. للتخطيط المستقبلي القريب. Okay, near future. Sam Miguel, what are you doing tonight? What are you doing tonight? Do you want to go bowling? Do you want to go bowling? I would love to, but see, first you say a nice word, then the excuse. I would love to, but I am sorry. I would love to, but I can't. I am going to a soccer match with my brother. See? Because it is rude. It is rude to say no directly. If someone invites you, don't say no. It's so rude, so impolite. First, say, I would like to. Thank you for inviting me. But I will be happy to go with you. But, okay? First, say a nice word, then your excuse. Oh, well, maybe some other time. Are you doing anything tomorrow? We could go then. Tomorrow sounds fine. I am going to work until 5. So let's go around 6. Okay? Afterward, maybe you can get some dinner. Sounds great. Did you understand what I was saying about this tense? Present, progressive, for plans in the future. Good. See the grammar focus. Future with present continuous. With present continuous, we are What are you doing tonight? This is in future. Planning. I am going to a soccer match. Are you doing anything tomorrow? No, I'm not. With present simple, going to and the verb. Present simple, going to and the verb. This is future, not planning. Okay? What is she going to do tomorrow? Okay? This is present simple. Future simple. Future simple, sorry. Okay? What is she going to do tomorrow? She's going to work until 5. This is not planning. This is for sure. This is for sure. You will 100% do it. Okay? But the planning, maybe you will do it, maybe not. But it is your plan for tomorrow. For near future. Okay? The difference or the difference between present continuous in the future, near planning and daily planning. Future simple means 100% you will do it in the future. Okay? Let's see here this exercise. Complete the invitations in column A with the present continuous used as future. Complete the responses in column B with be going to. Future simple. Okay, number one. What are you doing tonight? Planning. Okay. What are you doing tonight? What are you planning for tonight? Okay. Would you like to go out? The response in future simple. I am going to be. I am going to be here on Saturday. I am going to be here on Saturday, but not Sunday. Let's try and go on Saturday. And number two, planning. Are you doing anything on Friday night? Do you want to see a movie? Okay, let's do the column A completely, then do the column B fully, then we match. Number two, are you doing anything Friday night? Do you want to see a movie? Number three, we are having friends over for a barbecue on Sunday. Would you and your parents like to come? Number four, Are you staying? Are you staying in town next weekend? Do you want to go for a hike? Okay. B. I am going to be here on Saturday, but not Monday. Let's try and go on Saturday. B. Well, my father is going to visit me. My father? No, my father is going to visit me. Future simple. My father is going to visit my brother at college. But my mother and I are going to be home. Are going to be home. We would love to come. C. Sorry, I can't. I am going to work. I am going to work overtime tonight. I am going to work overtime tonight. How about tomorrow night? Last one. We can or can we go to a late show? Can we go to a late show? I am going to stay at the office till 7. Match them. Match them. Okay? Put the correct question with the correct answer. Can I take a message? Can I take a message? If someone calling you and you're not answering, your brother or your sister answered the call. She says to the caller, can I take a message? Okay. Good morning, Parker Industries. Parker Industries. Hello, may I speak to Mr. Graham, please? I am sorry, she is not in. Can I take a message? Yes, please. This is Mr. Kale. Is that G-A-L-E? No, it is K-A-L-E. All right, please tell her our meeting is on Friday at 2:30. Friday at 2:30. And could you ask her to call me this afternoon? My number is 646-555-4031. The secretary confirming, saying the number again to make sure. 646-555-4031. Yes, Mr. Kale. I will give Ms. Graham the message. Thank you. Goodbye. Goodbye. These are some message statements with tell and ask. Message with tell and ask. Tell is giving information. Ask is asking about some information. Okay? Telling or tell is giving and telling some information. Ask is asking about some information you don't know. statement. The meeting is on Friday. Messages with a statement. Please tell Anne that. Please tell Anne that the meeting is on Friday. You understand? How do you send your information to other people? Please tell Anne that the meeting is on Friday. Could you tell her? Could you tell her? Please tell her that the meeting is on Friday. Light sentences. Would you tell her? Would you tell her that the meeting is on Friday? You understand this? How you are telling the statements to people who are going to take the messages. Understood? Hello? Okay, request. If you are requesting the man to take your message and pass it, can call me this afternoon. Please ask him. Please ask him. Ask him, not tell him. You can use tell him, which is no problem, but ask him. Why? Because the man you're telling him or you are asking him, maybe he will call, maybe not. Maybe he will call, maybe not. That's why you ask. Okay? Please ask him to call me this afternoon. Could you ask him to call me this afternoon? Would you ask him to call me this afternoon? Tell and ask. Ask for choice. Tell, giving information. These are some messages. You have to pass it to your boss, to your parents, to someone you're working. Easy. This is also homework. Read it with yourself and try to understand the new words and new vocabulary and the new information and knowledge. Okay? Cell phone. Read this article and try to understand. Inshallah, we will have a new lesson tomorrow.